Do you use Instagram? Well, let me show you how you can use JotForm as an Instagram agent. Hey, JotFormers, welcome back. I'm Kimberly. And like I mentioned, if you use Instagram and JotForm, you can absolutely use them together and have JotForm answer DMs, comment replies, story replies, and mentions. So as you can see, I'm currently in the desktop version of my workspace. And for this example, I'm going to use Penny, my penguin conservationist AI agent. So let's go ahead and edit our agent. Now it's going to automatically populate me in the Instagram channel, but I'm going to go up to the publish tab, and you can see on the left hand side, again, we are still in the Instagram agent. So if at any point in time you end up in another tab, just navigate to the Instagram agent. I'm going to choose to log in with Instagram. Now, because I'm already logged into my Instagram account on my desktop, it's going to automatically know to log me in there. So one thing to keep in mind too, is if you have a personal Instagram account, you're going to be asked at this step to change to a professional or a business account. So you can see here, the second step is going to be training your agent. So your agent can utilize your bio, your post, and your DMs to see how to better respond to your users. If you would prefer to have it not check one of these, you can absolutely uncheck. I'm gonna go ahead and choose next. Now it's going to look at my bio. It's gonna look at the content of my post and as well as my DMs. Now, one thing that I can give advice on here is if you want better answers, make sure to have as much content in your description of your post for your Instagram agent to pull from. Now, for example, this is a brand new Instagram account. It doesn't really have any DMs on it. So if you don't have any DMs like me, it's going to automatically skip that step. So you can see it's currently analyzing my 9 posts. All right, and we are good to go. So let's complete. And you can see that we are officially successfully connected. So if I click on the 3 dots, we can pause our agent if we would like for it to no longer send messages or comments, but we don't want to completely disconnect. You can absolutely pause. We can train our agent. This is going to take us right back to that previous step to look at the post, our bio, and our DMs. Knowledge base and agent persona is going to take us up to the train tab, and then disconnect is to completely disconnect your account. So if I jump over here to our knowledge base, of course, like I mentioned, it's going to look at our bio, our post, and our DMs. But if you want to give it more information, you can absolutely do that here. You can do that by typing in knowledge. You can utilize a link. If you have any PDFs or manuals, you can upload a file. If you have specific Q&As that you know you're going to get, you can add those in here. And if you have a YouTube account, Zendesk or Freshdesk, you can add that information in here to help your AI agent answer those questions you're going to get even better. Now, the other one was the AI persona. So I'm going to go up to the top tab. So if you want to change the tone of your voice, or if you want to change that response length, you can do that here. And you can even add in additional guidelines. Now, another thing in this train tab that I want to mention over on the left-hand side, if we come down here to actions, I have right here, the sentence contains give back. So keep that in mind, because I'm going to mention that once we're over in the publish tab. So anytime someone says give back, in a post, in our messages, is going to automatically start the penguin donation form. So let's go up here to publish. Now, if we scroll down, we see our agent ability. So like I mentioned, we can reply to DMs, we can reply to comments, to stories, and to mentions. Now, as soon as you have all these turned on, right down here, you can see we have our agent summary. So we can see what it's done before, as well as we can come up here to view the conversations. And if you want to share your Instagram agent, you can do that by copying this link. All right, let's get into our agent ability. So for reply to DMs, I'm going to click on my customize option. And here you can see we have 2 different options. We can either reply to all DMs or DMs with specific keywords. Now keep in mind, if you choose all DMs, your AI agent is going to respond to every single DM. So I just want to respond to DMs with keywords, and I'm gonna choose that give back option. So that way you can start that form filling process in the DMs. Now down here at the bottom, these advanced settings, this is going to be the same on every single option. So you have follower accounts. So maybe you only want to respond to newer accounts, maybe people or people who have less than 1,000 followers, or maybe you only want to have those connections with bigger brands. So you can choose above or below, and you can enter that follower account here. We also have a time window. So if you only want to reply during a specific time, maybe it's from 3 to 5 or 3 to midnight, you can enter that time right in here. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and turn both of those off for this example, and I'm going to save. All right, next up is going to be reply to comments. So let's do customize. And we can see we can do all posts. So we can reply to comments on all posts, or we can choose specific posts. So I'm gonna do the specific post, and you can see it's gonna pull up all the posts on my Instagram account. So I'm gonna choose this guy right here. And then we can choose all comments on that post or comments with specific keywords. So I am going to do the word donate. If you want to add in additional ones, just put a comma and you can add in more keywords. Now, this is one of my favorite pieces, is you can reply with a DM. So this is the really popular, hey, comment link and I'll send you the link to your DMs. This is how you can do that with JotForm. So right here, it's already turned on reply with DM. We can reply with our knowledge base, or we can reply with a very specific message. So if someone's talking about donating, we can say, great, here's that link. And then we can turn on a button. We can have the button say donate now, and we can put that link in here. So for this example, I'm just gonna do jotform.com just so we can see what that button looks like. And then we can reply with a comment. So I'm going to reply right here. And then of course right here, it gives you an example. Thanks for your comment, check your DM. Thanks for your comments, check your messages. Okay, perfect. And then again, we have the same advanced setting. I'm going to save. Perfect. All right, let's do reply to stories. Now with this, again, we can do all stories or specific stories. I'm gonna leave it for all stories right now because I only have one story up right now. And we can do all story replies, replies with specific keywords, or we can do story reactions. So I'm gonna do story reactions, and I'm gonna choose that fire emoji. And then the same thing, and we can answer with our knowledge base, or we can say exactly. So I'm gonna do say exactly, and let's do thanks for your engagement. We'll change that right there. And then of course we can do the same thing when you show the button, if you're wanting to do some type of a link there, and then the advanced settings at the bottom. So let's save. And the last one is reply to mentions. We can do customize. So this is anytime someone mentions you in a story. So for example, maybe you're running a contest and you say, hey, take a picture of what have you, put it in your stories and tag me. You can do this. So let's do thanks for your mention. And then again, if you want to turn on the link, and you can also, again, same advanced settings, the follower count and the time window. So if you're running a contest, hey, the most mentions or whoever mentions between 5 and 6 gets entered into something. So you can do that here. So we have that. Thanks for the mention. I'm going to save, and we are set up. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and take my phone and let's go ahead and jump over to my Instagram account. We have it right here, and we can see this little guy walking right here. It has 0 comments. So I am going to say, I'd like to donate. We'll do send. Okay, let me do a quick refresh. We can scroll down. All right, we have that 1 comment. If I click on that, and we see we have the I'd like to donate, and we also have that reply. Thanks for your support. You can make a donation by clicking the link in our bio. All right, I am going to go ahead and head back. I'm gonna jump up to the stories, and I'm going to do the fire emoji. We can see it right down here. We have that fire emoji, right? Thanks for your engagement. Now I'm going to say, I'd like to give back. So we should see it come back with starting to fill out that form, because one, we said, yes, you can reply to DMs that have the word give back. And then the give back was in the train tab under actions, kind of like conditional logic to start filling out that form. And then of course, the same thing is going to happen whenever we do our story mention. Now, a couple of things I want to mention, if for any reason you want to change your password, you can absolutely do that from within here. So I'm gonna come over here to more. We're gonna come up to settings, and then we're going to see more in our account center. And we're gonna choose our password and security, change password, and we can change our password from here. Now keep in mind, if you change your password, you will need to reconnect your AI agent. Now, if for any reason you want to completely remove, not just disconnect, completely remove JotForm from your Instagram agent, you can absolutely do that as well. I'm gonna X out of this. And I'm gonna scroll down to the bottom. I'm still over here under settings. And right under here, under your app and media, we're gonna choose website permissions, apps and websites. And then of course, right here, you have your Instagram Messenger. You can completely remove that from here. Now, if for any reason you have a session invalid, like a 400 session invalid error for your Instagram agent, definitely come to this help article. It's going to give you step-by-step instructions on how to change that or how to fix it, why it happens, and how to fix it. Of course, you can clear the cache, use incognito mode. Be sure to check your account type. Like I mentioned, if it's a personal account, you're going to want to make sure it is a business or a professional account. Verify your login activity. Update your password if asked, kind of like what we just talked about. Switch networks or use another device or browser. Of course, if none of this works, be sure to contact support. And you have both JotForm's Help Center and Instagram Help Center. Now, if you have any issues with two-step verification, there's also this really great help article that'll help you hear what it is and why you're having trouble. And if we scroll down, we can see how to fix those common errors. So of course, making sure that your phone has a strong signal. If you're using an authentication app, make sure that it is synced properly. Or maybe you're having a device issue or an app issue. Maybe it is a security check. And of course, those last resort options, we have those backup codes that Instagram sends you. Now, if you need any other help support from that ways, again, JotForm support or Instagram support can definitely help. And it's as simple as that. If you have any questions about how to connect your Instagram account to JotForm so you have the ability to respond to comments, stories, DMs, and mentions, let us know down below in the comments. If you like this video and you got some value, hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe and turn on the bell so you get a notification every time we put out a new video. I'll see you next time.